Hi, this is Joe Choroszewski. Welcome to my online video lessons. In this particular lesson, I'd like to look at a concept that I've been practicing a lot lately. It's going to take us into the Latin fusion and Latin funk context, and the goal is to be able to play more freely with our hands over a repetitive bass drum pattern. This concept comes to me as a result of two separate influences, the first being my studies with Ed Sof at the University of North Texas. Ed often encouraged us to develop freedom with stickings, that's different combinations of right and left with our hands all over an ostinato foot pattern, which could be something like this Afro-Cuban pattern that we're going to do, or a Brazilian samba type pattern, or anything else we could come up with. The other influence comes from my studies of David Garibaldi's drumming and teaching materials. Garibaldi really pioneered the concept of groove permutations, where a pattern can be taken and then shifted to each different part of the beat, and each part of the measure resulting in a completely different groove each time the pattern is shifted, but all using the same pattern as a source material. He does a lot of this also with paradiddles, and this can be seen in the first few pages of his book Future Sounds, where the paradiddles initially start on the beat, and then he moves them to each 16th note and each triplet, resulting in really different grooves. So I applied that concept to playing over the Afro-Cuban Tumbao bass pattern to come up with all these exercises, and that's what I'm going to demonstrate. First, here's a simple demonstration of the ostinato that we're going to play with the feet. This is the Afro-Cuban Tumbao bass pattern in a real common context. The left foot is just going to click quarter notes on the hi-hat, while the right foot on the bass drum is going to play the syncopated pattern, which, if we count as 16th notes, would be and. No downbeats are involved. And. So here's a slow demonstration of that pattern with just the feet at quarter note equals 65. Now, here's the first single paradiddle that we're going to use. This is the standard paradiddle on the downbeat. I'm going to accent the downbeats, and it's going to be played starting on the downbeats. So first, here's a demonstration on one drum of this paradiddle at the slow tempo. Now, I'm going to put it together with the feet. I'm going to take the hands and split them up, putting the right hand on the ride cymbal pad, which I have assigned to a hi-hat sound, and the left hand's going to stay on the snare drum, playing this paradiddle pattern with the Tumbao bass foot pattern. We're going to start with the slow tempo, quarter note equals 65. Here's the same pattern a notch faster, quarter note equals 85. And finally, here's the same pattern at a much faster tempo, quarter note equals 125. Now we're going to deal with our first shifted paradiddle. This is still a single paradiddle, but I'm going to be starting it on the second 16th note of each beat. That's the E if we're counting 1E, 2E. That's the starting place for each paradiddle. So here's a demonstration of that on a single drum at quarter note equals 65. Now, same thing. I'm going to take that same shifted paradiddle pattern and I'm going to split it up and put it over the foot pattern, resulting in our first shifted paradiddle over the Tumbao bass. Here it is at quarter note equals 65. Now, a notch faster at quarter note equals 85. Same thing. And finally, much faster at quarter note equals 125. Now the method of shifting will continue as we start the paradiddle in the third 16th note, which is commonly known as the upbeat, the ands of each beat. One, and two, and three, and. That is the starting place now for the paradiddle. So here's a demonstration of that on one drum. And following suit, here it is split up on the drums now over the foot pattern. The next three segments will follow the same tempo shifts I've been previously doing. Quarter note equals 65, followed by 85, and then finally 125. Now, this is the final shift that we'll do for this lesson, and possibly the most difficult one. I'm going to take the paradiddles now and start them on the fourth 16th note, commonly known as the ah. One, ah two, ah three, ah four, ah one. That's the starting place now. So here's a demonstration of this shift on a single drum. And finally, here's that last shifted paradiddle as the full pattern following the same three tempos. And there you have it, the single paradiddle shifted to all four 16th notes of a single beat as the starting place. In the next chapter, I'm going to explore what happens when we leave the starting place the same, paradiddle's just starting on the downbeat, but we start to shift the accents to all four places, all four 16th notes, but leaving the placement of the paradiddle the same. So be sure to check that out. Thanks for watching.